End-to-end encryption is an advanced security feature that Hourglass is happy to make available. There are, however, some important things to know before enabling it for your congregation. In many branch territories, end-to-end encryption is not required to comply with local privacy regulations. Whether end-to-end encryption is enabled or not, all data in Hourglass is encrypted both in transit and at rest. End-to-end encryption provides an additional layer of security in that only individuals who possess your congregation's master password can view personal information such as names, addresses, and phone numbers. Once you enable end-to-end encryption, anyone with access to view such personal information will be required to enter the master password each time they log in, either through their web browser or using the mobile app. This means that all administrators, group overseers, and anyone else with such permissions will need to know the master password. After enabling end-to-end encryption, you will be able to set a new field for each publisher called the label. The label provides a descriptive name for the publisher that will appear for anyone who does not have the master password. If you don't set a label, publishers using the app won't be able to see the names of those who are assigned parts on the meeting. That's because their name is personal information, which is encrypted with your congregation's key. In some branch territories, a name is not considered private information, and so a publisher's full name can be entered for the label. In other cases, something less identifying, such as an abbreviation, might be used. Finally, the importance of securing and sharing the master password cannot be overstated. If your congregation loses its master password for any reason, there is no way that any of the encrypted information can be recovered. All personal data, including names, addresses, phone numbers, and emergency contacts, will be lost forever.